Alright people, welcome back. More card reviews. So today we are looking at Zushin the Sleeping Giant. Okay. So, I'm not sure if this was like maybe in the original Yu-Gi-Oh! I'm not sure. I never finished the original Yu-Gi-Oh! I know, shame on me. I finished GX, I finished 5Ds. I'm not gonna finish Zexal. And I'm watching Arc V, but nope, never finished the original Yu-Gi-Oh! So go ahead and crucify me. So, I'm not sure if this is, like, one of the monsters in the show or something, but we had a kind of interesting happenstance when it comes to this card. So, I guess I'll go ahead and talk about it now. So, of course, Fake Card Friday, you guys are able to send me fake cards, send it to me, and then I'll go ahead and see, like, well, this will be an interesting thing to do a video about. Well, someone sent me a fake card, and it happened to be Zushin the Sleeping Giant. I didn't think anything of it, because, of course, I've never seen it before. So, it's like, okay, well, for Fake Card Friday, we'll go ahead and do this. And then all of a sudden, Zushin, the actual playable card, got revealed. And I was like, what the heck? So, yes, for Fake Card Friday, we're going to be looking at Zushin, the fake card that someone made, and comparing it to the real one that Konami made. So, that's just an incredible happenstance. It just happened to pop up like this. So, that's how we're doing Zushin today, so we can go ahead and look at the fake card on Friday and be like, oh, look how close they were. Or, you know, which one do we like better, the fake card one or the one that Konami actually made? So, let's go ahead and look at the real one, look at the fake one on Friday, and, of course, compare. So, Zushin is a Earth Warrior Effect Monster, level 10. So, Mound of the Bound, Prown, Bound, Gown, Town Creator, if you want to. But, zero attack, zero defense. Level 10, zero attack, zero defense. Yubel? let's go ahead and read that effect. So, cannot be normal summoned or set. Okay. Must be special summoned from your hand, okay, by tributing one monster with 10 Zushin counters. It cannot be special summoned by other ways. Okay, so tribute monster with 10 Zushin counters. I'm assuming that this will put the counters on. Alright. Once per turn, you can reveal this card in your hand until the end of this turn. So you reveal it. Then target one level one. What? Target one level one normal monster? Is that like Bunzilla and like Charcoal and Palti and stuff? Like, okay. You control. Place one Zushin counter on it. Okay. So you're telling me that you have to keep a level one normal monster on the field for essentially 10 of your turns, 20 turns in duel. Some duels don't even last 20 turns. 10 turns of your duel. And it's not like you're going to jump out the bushes and stab your opponent with it. You know, every single turn you reveal it, put a counter on it, and then have it revealed till the end of the turn. So you're like, hey, I got this Zushin. I'm preparing for Zushin. I'm preparing for Zushin, you know? It's kind of like that one ghost trick, so cute bot. It's like, yeah, you get like, what, 10 XC materials, you win the duel? Yeah, like you're totally going to get that off. I kind of feel like this is in the same boat. Like, you're totally going to get 10 counters on a level 1 normal monster, and your opponent's just going to let them go. Like, you got to go all out and protect. And this thing, that there's just so many different angles that can come from getting that monster, that it's just going to be really difficult to protect that monster, whether it be, you know, protecting it from, you know, Regeki or Castell, or just being destroyed by battle. There's just so many angles that you can go ahead and come after that level 1 monster. So, let's go ahead and see if it's worth it. So, this guy's on the field. He is unaffected by other card effects. I mean, if you're going to put 10 counters on a level 1 normal monster for that long, you deserve to be pretty much invincible. So, another invincible monster. So, and let's get off a little bit topic, all right? Tower Turbo. All right, everybody knows towers. They fucking suck in Tower Turbo. All right, it's banned. Okay. Scouts at 1. Chicken Game is banned. Upstarts at 1. Wavering Eyes is banned. Tell me, how the fuck are you supposed to do Tower Turbo? You know? Like back when it was time to hit Cleese and Tower Turbo, I was like, just hit Wavering Eyes and Tower Turbo will fall apart, because there was no Tower Turbo before Wavering Eyes. As soon as Wavering Eyes came out, that just shows how powerful Wavering Eyes was. Tower Turbo existed. That whole popping both your scales to get any search of a pendulum-based monster, powerful, and rightfully so. 3 to ban? Not a lot of cards go 3 to ban. But Towers, still ban. Scout, still one. You know, I guess it was part of the Duelist Alliance era, and not a lot of decks survived that. Burning Abyss, what the fuck? How are you still a top tier deck? Tier 1 since your existence in August 2014 is ridiculous, but, so, Invincible Boss Monster, Towers, bam. But Megazord, nah, he's fine. Freaking, this card, fine. Freaking, Demonaga, fine. Freaking, and of course, Ultimate Falcon coming out soon, so, But, yeah, I mean, this guy is probably one of the more difficult ones. You know, I'd probably rather go for Vemina Naga than try to have a level 1 normal monster stay on the field for 10 of my turns and put a counter on each turn. But it's cool that you're unaffected by card effects, but you're 0 attack and 0 defense, so what's up with that? If this card, this card's attack and defense becomes equal to the attack of the opponent's battling monster plus 1,000 during damage calculation only. So you're like, what, Wicked Avatar? You'll always be 1,000 attacks stronger? Also, what about that that Legendary Knights? Didn't they have, like, that one fusion guy who you pretty much bust him out and you win? So, interesting, interesting. So, this guy's unaffected by card effects. He will always be 1,000 attack and defense higher than the monster that it's battling. So, it's pretty much invincible, right? No. Because you see, similar to almost all the invincible monsters, besides, like, what, the Megazord, because it's a fact. This card is very susceptible to Utopia the Lightning. Yep. Because, of course, Utopia the Lightning kind of affects the player, not the card. So while this card is unaffected by card effects, Utopia the Lightning says you cannot do anything as a player, which means that you cannot activate Zushin's effect to gain that 1,000 attack boost over him. So pretty much, summon Utopia the Lightning, attack, Zushin's dead. Like, it's just ridiculous. And of course, don't get started on them kaijus. Just, hey, you wasted 10 of your turns putting counters on this normal monster, trying to keep him on the field, trying to bust out this powerful Zushin, and your opponent just goes, alright, well, tribute off for a kaiju. Like, it's more likely to hold Utopia Lightning because that's an extra deck, so you need to slide that in or have kaiju's main deck, but just the thought of getting this hella hard to work out boss monster just being crushed like that. Just Utopia Lightning. You know, not everybody has it, but, you know, if you're dueling in America, Utopia Lightning attack, gone. It's just like, wow. So, I don't know. Like, if you can get it out, and your opponent has no answers, then he's pretty powerful. I mean, it kind of sucks that he doesn't have any attack of his own, so he's only getting strength off of what he battles. So if your opponent just, you know, takes the stall game and keeps on setting monsters, I mean, the duel's going to take forever. It's not like you can, like, oh, well, I have, like, Towers or Megazord who just have hella high attack on their own. Like, this guy is only as strong as the monster that he battles plus 1,000, so, yeah. But, it's just, I'm just not sure how I feel about this card. It's just too much effort just to be wrecked by Utopia the Lightning. It really is, so. Anyway, there is Zushin the Sleeping Giant. So, like I said, go ahead and tell me what you guys think about this card in the comment section below, and whether you would actually take the time and effort to make a deck, and how would you go about it? You know, how would you go about keeping that level 1 normal monster on the field to summon now Zushin? And of course, Fake Off Friday, we'll be looking at the fake one and seeing how similar they are and which one is better. So look forward to that. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this card review. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all support. And yeah, see you guys next week with some more cards to look at in card review. All right, people. Thanks for watching.